Hi, this is Carol Bremner from carolbremner.com, and this is day 24 of my 30-day challenge. Today, I need to set up a GoToWebinar invitation because a GoToWebinar session because I'm planning to have a webinar on October 31st to celebrate my 30 days. So I'm starting here at my desktop. And as you can see, this beautiful scene is what I wish it was like today in Canada today, even though it's not the end of October yet. We've had snow already, although it didn't stay on the ground, thankfully. Okay, so I've got my GoToWebinar. I've already installed GoToWebinar, downloaded it to my computer. So I have this shortcut here. So I'm just going to click that. And I want to schedule a webinar. So it takes me right to the GoToWebinar website. And I'm just going to move this over a little bit. So I'm going to, I set up my webinar here. So I could schedule a similar webinar to one I've done before, which I'm not going to do. So I'm going to do a new one. So I just need to type in the name, and I'm going to does Hootsuite Hootsuite's perfect partner. And we'll just say that. So now here you have to put in some kind of a description, and I'm just going to say a very short one for now for the sake of time. So Hootsuite has found the perfect match, and her name is, and I'm going to leave that so that you'll have to come to the webinar to find out. So I want it to be on October 31st, and I don't want it to be in the evening because it's Halloween and I don't like mornings necessarily. So I'm going to have it at 1 o'clock. So I'll say 1 and change this to PM. And I like to have them just a half an hour. So I'll put that as 1:30 PM. And my time zone is already Eastern time and does not recur. So I'm not, it's just a one-time shot. I could have it that it goes daily, weekly, or monthly, but I'm going to choose does not recur. And for audio, you can use the built-in audio conferencing. So mic and speakers and long distance for anyone who'd like to phone in. So I usually have both of those checked, and I'm going to edit this so they're long distance numbers for not just Canada, but also the United States and the UK. And then we'll save that. And you can use your own conference call service. I've never done that. Now, panelists, if there were some panelists there, then I could put them in, but I, and see, it's given me some information here that I can put their names and email address. So if you've got a guest, co-host or anything like that, or someone you're interviewing, you can put their information here, and then they'll be sent an invitation too. So I'm not going to be doing that, so I'll just leave that. And I'm going to click save and continue. And I didn't need a webinar password, so because it's for anyone who's registered. So now we're on the branding and theme, and I can upload a logo here, which would go at the top of the invitation. I'm not going to do that right now because it takes a little bit of time, but you would just look for it on your computer and upload it. And then you can choose a theme, and there are a number of them. This is the basic theme, which is quite plain. Then there's a business, PR, sales, and training. So I think I'm going to go with the business one this time. And you can also have a custom image for your theme. I've never done that either, but you can upload one if you want to. Now the waiting room, that's what people see when they come to the webinar before it starts. So you can have it any color you like. So I'm gonna make mine this color, similar to part of my website. And then you have to list the presenters that will be shown when people are in the waiting room. And that's including yourself. So I'm going to just put my name here. I won't put a title, but I'll put online success. And I would upload an image of myself as well. And then if there is another presenter, I would click them and do the same with them as well. So when attendees arrive, show them this welcome message. So I'll just say something like, guess who Hootsuite has been seeing. Find out soon. Now, normally I would do something like have a pen and paper ready or something like that, but I'm trying to make this one a little bit more fun. So you can preview the theme. So I'll click on that. I'll just move it over so you can see it. So this is what it looks like. All the things that I've put in so far. And then I want to preview the waiting room. So this is what the waiting room looks like. So people, when they come, this is what they'll see. And instead of this gray part, there would be an image of me, a photo. And if there were any other presenters, there would be a photo of them as well. So now I can save and continue. And this is where the registration form is filled in. So there are all kinds of different questions, and I don't like to do all these, so I'm going to clear all of them, because the more you ask people things, the less likely they are to fill it out. But first name, last name, and email address are required, because GoToWebinar will keep track of your registrants and send reminder emails before the webinar begins. So you can also create your own questions, which will be added to the registration form. So I'm just going to say something like, do you use Hootsuite? And I'm going to make it a required question. And you can have some answers here for people if you want to. So I can say yes in one, no in another, and sometimes I'll put in that one. And then I'm going to click create, and there it is. Do you use Hootsuite? So I'm going to click on it, and I'm going to click that I want it put up, and you'll see if I did it right, you'll see that it's on the page. So now it says, after registering, your registrants will receive an email with information about joining. So do you want them to get that email automatically, or do you want to approve them first? So I usually do automatically. And then you want to redirect them to your website after they've registered. So I'm just going to put my website address here. And now we can preview it again. So as you can see, there's just a little bit here in the text about Hootsuite finding the perfect match, because I haven't put much in there, but you can put as little or as much as you like. And let's see if my question is there. Yes, it is. Do you use Hootsuite? And then people can choose which of those responses. And so they would fill in that information and click register now. So that's, I'm gonna make it a little smaller so you can see it. So that's how it looks there. And so now I'm going to click save and email me the invitation. And That's done. So now the invitation is going to be mailed to me, and I can make sure people have that link. I can put it up for on a website or whatever I'd like to do. So I can edit the registration later, and there are a few different things I can do. And if I decided I wanted to cancel it, I would do that here. And that's all there is to it. So that's it for setting up a GoToWebinar. And tomorrow I need to update my Facebook page so that I can let them know about this webinar event. So I hope you can join me for that. See you later. Bye-bye.